Dear students, in the last class we have discussed that cell. What is cell and what is, why it is called as the basic unit of life. Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Okay, different types of parts that present inside a cell are called cell organelles. We have already discussed that cell membrane. Cell wall. We completed. Now I am going to explain about the nucleus. Structure of the nucleus and what it function. To know about the nucleus, we have to perform one activity. How to observe the nucleus? For this, I am going to conduct one activity. So for this activity, we require some materials. What are the materials we require? That is toothpick, glass light, watch glass, cover slip, methylene blue, glycerin, normal saline, needle. So these are the materials we require. Toothpick or ice cream spoon or spatula. So toothpick I have taken here. Glass light, watch glass, cover slip, methylene blue, glycerin, saline, normal saline and needle. So procedure. How to observe that? The nucleus in the human cheek cell, nucleus in human cheek cell. So cheek cells, vocal lobe. We are going to observe this one, nucleus in the human cheek cells. In the procedure, wash your mouth and scrape a little of internal lining of your mouth with the help of the toothpick. Once again, wash your mouth and scrape a little of the internal lining of your mouth and place this in a watch glass. Which contains saline, normal saline. Next one. Remove this one and transfer this material into the glass line. Scrapping material into the glass light and add a few drops of methylene blue and wait for a few seconds. First one, scrap the internal lining and place it in the watch glass and transfer watch glass which contains the normal saline and transfer this material onto the glass slide. Next point, add a few drops of methylene blue over the glass light and wait for a couple of minutes. Next, so wipe the excess of stain with help of the blotting paper or cloth. Here we have to add another material, blotting paper. So wipe the excess of stain with help of the blotting paper. Now add glycerin on it. And take this slide and observe under the microscope. So if you observe under the microscope, you notice that the human cheek cells may appear like this. So the nucleus is present, the liquid portion is cytoplasm, and some other organelles also present here. Okay, so this is the experiment procedure. Nucleus in the observing of nucleus in the human cheek cell, scrap your internal lining of mouth with the help of the toothpick and place this in a watch glass which contains normal saline. Transfer this material onto the watch glass, add methylene blue and wait a couple of minutes. Next, add glycerin to it. Okay, and wipe the edges off. Same. Next, cover the material scrap with the cover slip. Cover it with cover slip and observe the under microscope. Tap the cover slip with the help of the blunt end of the needle to spread the scrap in the uniform manner. It should be the scrap. The scrap should be distributed equally on the slide. Okay. Now we observe this type of figures. So here, what do you understand this one? The dark dot-like structure that present inside the cell is called nucleus. The dark dot-like structures inside the cell is nucleus and cytoplasm is surrounded around itself. Okay, so this is the experiment. For every experiment, we have to follow some precautions. So what are the precautions we have to take? So precautions: do not scrap too hard your mouth, it may injure you. Wipe the excess of stain on the watch glass. Next, what's the extra stain? Do not scrap too hard. Okay, either the scrap should be uniformly distributed, uniformly spread on the slide. These are the precautions, three precautions. So the dark-like structure is nucleus. Okay, now I am going to explain this nucleus. Studying about the nucleus is called karyolysis. Karyology. Studying about the nucleus is called karyology. The first time the nucleus was discovered by the Robert Brown. Who is he? Robert Brown. In the year 1831. The first cell was noticed or observed by the Robert Hooke. The first time the nucleus was discovered by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. In the starting, at the time that Brown did not know anything about it. That means about nucleus. He did not know anything about the nucleus. Just a dot-like structure is present, which appears larger than the remaining cell organelles. He noticed like that only. But it was known much more about the nucleus after the Robert Brown. So the nucleus is also called as cells control room. Very important points. Nucleus is also known as cells control room. It is the most largest and distinct part of the all cell organelles in the cell. It is the most distinct and largest part of remaining all cell organelles. Because of that, it's called cells control room. Schleiden, one of the proponents of cell theory. Cell theory was proposed by Schleiden and Schwann. Schleiden, one of the proponents of cell theory, thought that on those days, new cells are formed from the nucleus. So he called this nucleus as cytoblast. He called this one as cytoblast. So, nucleus was known as cells control room. It is the largest and most distinctive part than the remaining cell organelles. Okay, so Schleiden thought that it is the place where the new cells are created. Okay, new cells are created from the nucleus and call it as a cytoblast. So think once again. So number of cells are present in the human body, almost 120 trillions of cells. So we just found from the two cells, one from the mother and another from the father. So from the two cells, one is sperm and another one is ovum. From these two cells we are forming embryomas, uncountable numbers of nucleus cells are formed. So all these cells are formed from which part? From the two cells only the human body is developed. Every organ contains, everything is made up of cell. Okay, so how the body is look like, how it is formed? Yes, the cell is the basic unit of life. Cells, cells form these all organs, cells form these all body parts. Here, a group of cells. Forms tissues. A group of tissues forms organs. Organs forms organ system. And organ system consists of a living body. It forms the living body. So, hands, legs, hearts, kidneys, everything. Whatever the part, lungs, intestines, what are the part that present in the body is made up of the cells. A group of cells will form the tissues. Tissues forms organs. Organs forms organ system. All the organ system constitute to form a living body. Do you understand this one, boys? So, Sweden thought that on those days, new cells are formed from the nucleus. And he thought that it has a cytoplasm, but it was wrong. We will learn it in the coming lesson, in the coming part. So here, so what are the functions of the outside nucleus? The functions of the nucleus is, it is the cells control room. Okay, most largest and distinct part. Okay, next, almost all eukaryotic cells contain the nucleus. All eukaryotic cells contain the nucleus except the red blood cells in the few mammals and the phloem tubes in the plants does not constitute the nucleus. Okay, except these two, remaining almost all eukaryotic cells contain the nucleus. Nucleus is necessary in a living cell. Because it is the cells control room. Except the few exemptions of red blood cells in some mammals like camel and llama. Camel and llama and the phloem tubes in the plants that does not have the nucleus in their cells. And remaining all contain all eukaryotic cells contain nucleus. Even in the beginning, these mammals and plants also contains nucleus, but later it was thrown out from the cell and destroyed. Do you understand? So the cell nucleus. I already told you that studying about the nucleus is called karyology. So karyology. Nucleus determines the characteristic of an organism. What are the characters that you have? This becomes in the or this is exhibited or controlled by this nucleus. Characters are governed by this. Okay? Characters are controlled by the nucleus. It also involves in the cell division, the process of cell division. It contains the all genetic information. The genetic bank of the cell is nucleus. Okay? So, genetic information is present. Once again, I will say, okay? This is the largest and most distinctive part of all cell organelles in the cytoplasm. It is also called as cells control room. It is the it controls all the characteristics of an organism. It contains all genetic information. It also involves in the closely involves in the cell division. Cell division. It will determine the shape and structure of the cell also. So these are the points. Hi there. Here. The structure of the nucleus is surrounded by a membrane bound structure. The nucleus is surrounded by a membrane that is called nuclear membrane. The nucleus is surrounded by a nuclear membrane. Okay. So, the membrane that covers the nucleus is called nuclear membrane, which separates the nucleus from the cytoplasm. Okay, so on the basis of presentation of the nuclear bound membrane or nucleus, the organisms, that means the cells that present in the organisms, as categorized into two types. One is eukaryotic cells. Second one is prokaryotic cells. So eukaryotic and prokaryotic cells. And the presentation of the nucleus membrane bound, nuclear membrane bound nucleus is present. These are called eukaryotic cells, plants and animal cells. If the nuclear membrane is absent, those cells are called prokaryotic cells. And the basics, on the basic of, or on the depending on the nucleus, the cells which contain the nucleus are called eukaryotic cells. Which do not have the nucleus, prokaryotic cells. Okay. So up to here we discussed two types of cells. In the first section, we noticed that the peel of onion cells. So plant cells we have already discussed that. The plant cells are looking like this. Plant cells. Animal cells. So if you observe carefully, onion peel cells and human cheek cells, there is a difference in the structures of some of the organelles. What is the structures? In the plant cells, cell wall is present. Here, in animal, if you think it's a plant cell, this one is animal cell. Here, cell membrane is the outermost layer. So, cell membrane, cell wall is present. Here, cell wall is absent. And another one is, the nucleus is present at the center of the animal cell. But here, the nucleus is present at the center of the plant cell. So, two differences we found here. In the animal cells, nucleus is present at the center. But in the plant cells, nucleus is present at the side of the center. In the plant cells, we can find that chloroplast is present. What is that? Chloroplast is present. Here, chloroplast is absent. Chloroplast is absent. In both cells, mitochondria is present, ribosomes are present, Golgi complex is present, endoplasmic reticulum is present, everything are present, but the plant cells only contains the chloroplast. Are all the plant cells contain the chloroplast? No. Only the green colored parts like leaves and the tender stem only contain the chloroplast. If you observe the bark of the plant, it may not contain chloroplast. If you observe the fruit, it does not have the chloroplast. Roots does not have the chloroplast. Only the green parts of the plants like leaves and the tender stems only contain the chloroplast. So, this is one of the major differences between the plant and animal cells. Plant cells contain chloroplast, animal cells that do not have the chloroplast. Here nucleus, in plant cells, nucleus is present aside, but here nucleus is present at the center. And one more difference is the vacuoles. Vacuoles, it performs the excretion function. Vacuoles are very larger in size. In animal cells, vacuoles are very small in size. Do you understand this? Vacuoles are very larger in the and plant cells, very small in the animal cells. So like this, we have discussed that nucleus. Okay, so very important points about the nucleus. It is the cells control room, largest and most distinct part. It controls the all characteristics of an organism. It contains all genetic informations. It involves in the cell division. Okay, students, this is enough for today. Thank you.